Good morning, everybody. Myself, Sheetal Singhal, Chief Manager, HSE, GAIL. These are the contents of my presentation. Basically, natural gas pipeline, hazards associated with that, major causes of accident and best practices, what we are following, and challenges in pipeline. Natural gas is actually a naturally occurring hydrocarbon, so I'll not take much time on this because everybody here is from oil and gas industry, so you must be knowing what is natural gas. And as Hirak Datta sir has said, that natural gas is right now the fuel of time. So we have to be specific about natural gas. Cross-country pipelines in India, they are increasing day by day, and as it is a system by which natural gas is flowing from one place to one location to another. And with increase in sophisticated technologies and increased applications, these pipelines are gaining advantage over other means of transport like trucks and all. This is the hydrocarbon pipeline network in world, and India, we can see it is at the nascent stage. So these are the right now pipelines which are available, which are present in India, and GAIL is expanding this network also on eastern side. That is, GHBDPL pipeline is coming, and that will form a grid network. So what is a natural gas pipeline system consist of? Main elements is the buried pipeline, which is going from, which is a cross-country pipeline, and some above-ground pipelines, which is mainly coming in the stations. Then compressor stations for boosting that gas pressure, isolation valves for isolation and handling any emergencies and even maintenance part, relief valves, pipe bridges, supports, casings, leavings, leak detection system, pig launcher, receiver, and control system. All these are part of a natural gas pipeline system. As you know, natural gas is a highly flammable substance. So when it is transported through cross-country pipelines at high pressure, it often closes to highly populated areas, and through even highly environmental sensitive areas. So it poses severe hazards to human being and property in the vicinity. Basically, the protective measures what we are taking for safe operation of natural gas pipeline are based on the hazardous properties of natural gas and quantity of natural gas at what pressure it is being operated. This is a small scenario. This is the hazards of natural gas. This is a small video. The hazards associated with natural gas is flash fire and jet fire. This is a small video showing jet fire. The pressure at which the gas is releasing. This is the explosion in case, this can also happen in case of a natural gas pipeline. This is taken from the actual incident which has happened in a natural gas pipeline. Major causes of accident, what we are dealing in pipeline, natural gas pipeline, is the first one is the pilferage. That is the, they're trying to take out through hot tapping and all. But in natural gas, it is not very easy to do that. But in cases of crude pipelines and petroleum pipelines, this is being done. So in that case also, that is there is a danger that people may think it of a crude pipeline and they may puncture the line. Then there is a third party interferences and corrosions, equipment failure, improper maintenance and inspection, and others. When we see that OSD statistics of cross-country pipeline accidents, major accidents are happening due to pilferage and third party interferences, like JCB operating for the urbanization and all, or roads. Then equipment failure and poor maintenance inspection makes the next part. That accumulates to 36%. When we go for the best practices for natural gas pipeline, what we follow in our GAIL, we go for HSE leadership and commitment. First, we main emphasis is on HSE leadership and commitment, risk assessment, construction and design, operation and maintenance activities, training and competencies, inspection, IT support, and societal capacity building. Leadership and commitment is formulating and maintaining HSC policy goals and objectives. As in the last session, we have talked about that on culture building also. So like that, we are having a strong HSC management system in GAIL, and we are formulating standard operating procedures. Then there are policies, guidelines for all the stations in GAIL. We allocate necessary resources to meet these requirements and to promote HSE culture and its assessment periodically, as like Dr. Garg has discussed in the last session. We have brought this BBS in GAIL in 2013, and after that, in 2018, we have started for focusing on, after BBS, we are starting focusing on the building leadership qualities among the supervisors who are there at the sites. Means it's a safety leadership being built through coaching, mentoring them, and through social learnings. We encourage engagement and leadership of all levels. We say that safety leadership starts from the top, but it goes till further down, till the supervisor level. Even a worker who is at a workplace, he is also a safety leader. We conduct periodic HSC management system reviews, and in GAIL, we have a practice that we have a monthly safety day at all the sites on 10th of every month, in which GAIL, in which the OIC at the site, he discusses all the audit points, safety observations, near misses reported in that month, and those points are then being compiled and sent to corporate office, corporate HSE department, and those points are then discussed in the monthly safety review meeting held by our directors. Two directors are there, and we are discussing all those points, and all the sites are connecting through VC. So in case any issue is there, in case of any resources availability, that can be ensured by the involvement of top management. And it's 5 years we have completed, and we have never missed this monthly safety review by the directors. Risk assessment is another part for best practices. We identify the emergent pollutable risks which are there in the pipeline system and determine the risk acceptance criteria. We brought it to TOLA ALARP level, and then we move further. There are hierarchy of controls for reducing the risk. In design and construction, we adopt national and international codes and standards as minimum requirement. That is only as a minimum. We maintain more than the minimum requirements. We think beyond that, and we focus on inbuilt safety systems. Introducing of new technologies like SCADA, leak detection system, apps is there, corrosion monitoring, and pipeline intrusion system. That pipeline intrusion system, we are mainly focusing on the pipelines which are passing through the highly populated areas and where the urbanization is going on, and quality control. Just a minute. For this, there are some regulatory bodies. There are regulations like PNGRB, which is having a standard on that pipeline safety, that is T4S, and there is a ERDMP document also for that. And OSD, which has made a standard on natural gas pipeline 226, ASMEB 31.8, that's a standard on natural gas transmission, and it tells about the construction also. Operation, maintenance, and inspection. We are maintaining safety in a consistent manner with the specified requirement of regulations and national and international applicable codes and standards. We have formulated SOPs. We have made the process safety information at all our plants. We have implemented integrity management system as per PNGRB T4S standard. We are focusing on the quality of outsourced manpower. That is also a criteria when we are placing an order, like last it was discussed, on outsourced manpower. So we have included it as in a part of our GCC. Training and competencies. We engage employees having minimum qualifications as experience and experience as stipulated in codes and standards. We have engaged subject matter experts on aspects like pipeline corrosion. cathodic protection and inline ILI we are doing for the pipeline. That is an inline inspection, and it gives us that proper idea what is the health of the pipeline and how we can go further. Development of skilled and certified professionals like NACE and certified corrosion experts. We have also included IT support in maintaining a pipeline, like mapping of all the pipelines in GIS platform. Even a single place in a pipeline, if any incident happens, we can go to that village, we can get the information about that pipeline, what is in which survey number it is there, incident is there, and what are the administrative supports we can get, that directly we can get through that software. We have introduced CPIMS, Centralized Pipeline Integrity Management System, like it can be controlled through our NGMC, National Gas Management Center. Means in case of a failure of a RGMC, Regional Control Center, we can directly take control from the National Center, which is at Noida, Delhi. We have liberalized IT for safe work permits. It was since 2005 we have used it for work permit system. And now we have increased it the use to the using incident reporting, job safety analysis, management of change, even safety audits. What are being done by OSD and external audit, external agencies are brought to that. And societal capacity building, that is the must for pipeline operations. That is awareness of the surrounding villages which are there in the pipeline. And it is being done through radio jingle, video skits, Nukkad Nataks and all. We engage villagers of pipeline ROU through Sayogi scheme. We have collaborated with government authorities also on management of emergencies in hydrocarbon pipelines. These are the challenges what we are facing, like aging of pipeline is a major factor. Then societal awareness on pipeline, because that requires major attention of the public utility. Urbanization of nearby pipelines, third party damages, encroachments, and land acquisition. Thank you.